Hi friends. Today I'm going to speak something which is going to be very interesting, which is a very interesting topic for all of us. And if we try to implement this in our day-to-day life, we'll get to know the true importance of that which I'm going to speak right now. So friends, my name is Rashmi and I'm an IT professional. I have also completed my degree in counseling and hypnotherapy. Though I haven't practiced it on others, but definitely to myself, and found it to be really useful and effective in my own day-to-day life. So I felt that I should be sharing it with you all so that we can all give a try from our end. So the topic that I'm going to speak today is on aura. So we all know, most of you might have read about it or might have heard about it, what an aura is and what an aura can do in our day-to-day life and how it can have an impact in our life. So an aura is nothing but a human energy field. It's an energy field which encloses a human body or any object or anything that surrounds us. So any object will have an aura around it. Similarly with human as well. So human aura is primarily determined by the kind of thoughts that we feed in our mind. Thoughts are nothing but vibrations or energy again. So by the quality of thoughts that we feed in our mind, we form an aura around us. So we call this aura as subtle body sometimes, an invisible body. So it has got a direct link to the overall health of a person. So friends, when I say health, it is just not the physical health, but the overall health, like the mental health, emotional health and the spiritual health of a person. So that means an aura has the power to determine the life of a person. So now my next question to all of you is, how do we get this aura? Or how can I make my aura very strong enough so that I can ensure that I have a peaceful and a disease-free life? And what are a few simple tips, very simple tips that we can all adopt in our day-to-day life so that we can at least ensure that my aura is strong? So friends, before I move on to that, we all would have experienced the nature of this aura by, like, when we go to a certain place, we are not feeling comfortable, or when we go to certain other places like temples or mosque, we feel good in that area. It's all because of the nature of thoughts, thought energies that surrounds that area. If the energy or the vibration of a particular place is very low, we feel uncomfortable. At the same time, if the energy or the frequency is very high in certain areas, we feel very happy and high in our own minds. Okay, so keeping all these points in mind, let's get into very, very few simple tips which we can adopt in our day-to-day life without spending anything, which is free of cost, I mean. Okay, so the first one, the number one tip is getting up early in the morning. Okay, so when I say getting up early in the morning, I would definitely suggest that it's best to get up before sunrise. That is best. So I know that there are people who do night shifts or who cannot get up early morning. So that is an exceptional part which I will be including in my future videos. But if you're able to get up before sunrise, by around maximum by around 4:30, 4:45, before that, that is one of the best thing that I should be doing as my first thing. Okay, so getting up early in the morning, if not as much early as possible. Okay, so after getting up, the first and foremost thing is I can get into a prayer or whatever I believe in, or I can just sit simply closing my eyes for some time. I can get into meditation, which is one of the best thing to do. Whatever meditation practice you would like to adopt, you can go for it. No specificity that I'm mentioning here, but getting up early in the morning, Because that particular time before sunrise, which we call as Brahma Muhurat or Amrit Vela, is a very highly powerful time wherein our mind has the strongest potential, where the entire world is sleeping, and if I'm getting up early in the morning, I can do wonders, I would say. Okay, and that, in fact, I have practiced it in my own life. That's the reason I'm telling that here. We'll get into more details on it later. So get up early in the morning, first step. Do your prayers or meditation for some time. And next thing, you can do exercise. The second tip that I would mention here is do some physical exercise so that it stretches your body. Maybe a simple stretching exercise would do, wherein you feel that your entire body has got some movement. That is the second step. Okay. And thirdly, what can I do? Thirdly, go ahead and take your bath. Okay, so bath, it can be, I would suggest that all of us should be taking a cold bath in cold water. If not, those who have any kind of ailments or diseases or fever or anything, I would suggest they go for a hot water bath. If not, if you don't have any ailments or any diseases, go for a cold bath, under a cold shower. That would be the best thing. Okay, so now you're done with three things. One is getting up early in the morning, do your prayers or meditation. Secondly, do the exercise, which is stretching your body. Third is take bath in cold water. Okay, and the fourth tip that I'm going to suggest here is, like I would say around 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. between that time, I mean, that would be, I think, the best time wherein you should get some sunlight. You should get some sunlight exposed. You should have an exposure to the sunlight, I mean. Okay, the sunlight should fall on your body. It not only it not only improves your vitamin D, but at the same time, it also enhances your aura, and you will feel good about it. Okay. And the fifth, I would say, I think, how much did I say? Getting up early in the morning and then do your prayer or meditation. And the second one is going exercise. The third one is taking bath in cold water. And fourth one is exposure to sunlight. And the fifth one is a generalized thing which I'm going to say, and that is stick to a discipline. Okay, so when I say stick to a discipline, you should have a specific time assigned to any of your work. It's not just that today you do something, tomorrow you do something else at that time. If you stick to a discipline, your mind and body would be trained to do that on a day-to-day basis. So when that time comes, it's time for you to do that. So if possible, stick to a discipline. It will actually order your mind in a specific way so that it would be more easier, and your mind will not wander. You already know the plan. Okay, so have a discipline in place in your life. The last method or the last tip that I would say is the kind of thoughts that you feed into your mind on a day-to-day basis throughout the day. So how do I monitor my thoughts? What kind of thought comes into my mind? Because all these determine my aura, as I said, my kind of thoughts. Okay, so throughout the day, every 1 hour or every 2 hours, just keep a discipline for that as well. Every 2 hours, just monitor your thought. Just stop for 1 minute and then monitor what sort of thought I've been thinking for all this time. Did I have any waste or negative thoughts? If yes, then try to stop it, and then you cannot actually have zero thoughts in your mind, but definitely you can divert your thoughts from negative or waste to positive. So the level of thoughts that I should be having is of very strong and very great in nature. Say for example, I'm a very successful person, I'm a great soul, I'm a helping soul. Something of very, very, very great, or something which is for the universe. So have those thoughts in place, transform your current thoughts into them if you are not already having it. So for that, regularly monitor your thoughts repeatedly and ensure that you maintain it throughout the day. So if you follow this very, very simple 6 steps, I can promise you, or we can all ensure that we have a good aura around us, it will take practice. Please keep practicing it for some time. If you at least practice it for 1 month, I'm sure that you will get used to it. And it will actually give us a very strong mind and a very good aura, which in turn can have a good effect in our day-to-day life. So friends, hope you followed it and you will follow it in your life. So let's try it for another 30 days. And do let me know your comments and feedbacks after the results. Okay, so bye then. Bye for now. Let's all meet during the next video. Bye for now. Thank you.